Hello and welcome. My name is Kia and I'm coming to you from Sweden in a small village outside of Gothenburg. And this is my podcast where I share with you my crafty life. It's knitting, spinning, crochet today and sewing and embroidery and yeah, I do a lot of different crafts actually. Yes, on social medias you can find me on Instagram as kiasbod_podcast. I'm on Ravelry as kiasbod and I also have a website kiasbod.se where I have a little blog where I mostly do blog posts about my knitted garments, my finished things, but also other things. And you can also find all information about FreeSock 2020 there. And I will put up this film and all my podcasts is on my website with links to everything I talk about today and every other day. I'm sitting out in my garden today because we have 28 degrees here in Sweden. I don't know what that is in Fahrenheit, but it's hot. It's very hot and there is no way I will sit in the greenhouse. So there is the garden today and I have a big umbrella, what you call it, parasol over here. So this is a shadow. Place in the shadows all day, but the negative thing when we sit outside is the wind. So I am filming on my iPad, and I have a microphone on because I'm hoping that the wind won't be disturbing in the filming. Yes, I hope so. I have a year-long knit-along going. It's the FreeSock 2020, and that is I pick out a pattern, a free pattern from Ravelry every month, and you will knit from your stash mainly if you want to. I want to knit from my stash, so that's why I call it FreeSock 2020, because the point is that we knit up things that we already have, not to buy new things. And the patterns, there is so many lovely patterns on Ravelry that are free, so why not knit some of them? That was my plan. And this month we are knitting a new pattern. It came out this year in May and it's Petite Fleur, and it's Imawale is the designer, and I have seen that she is in the Ravelry group helping out, and I'm so grateful for that. Thank you so much if you are watching. It's a big help actually to have the designer helping out, because many questions pop up in the Ravelry group. So I'm so grateful that you are there to give some help to those who need it. There is a lovely group of people in my Ravelry group. I'm so grateful that you are there and keeping it alive, because I am lousy. I pop in sometimes and I read some things, but yeah, feel free to pop in there and join in the lovely group. Petite Fleur is a sock that you knit with the pattern says two colors, but you can use as many colors as you want, because I saw a picture. Someone was knitting like 2 centimeters of each color, has one bottom color, and then shifting, just using up scrap yarns, and it became so lovely. And you make the pattern. It's a striped sock, and you make the pattern with lifted stitches. So you don't carry 2 strands at the same time, only one thread at a time. And the sponsors for this month, I forgot to tell you that last week, and it is a Swedish cafe who also has a yarn webshop, and it's called Lövstrands Café, and I have links to everything on my website. There is a little headline. That's FreeSock 2020, and under that headline you can go in and find all information for every month with the sponsors and winners for the previous months and everything. So if you're interested in FreeSock 2020, go to my website and look under that headline, FreeSock 2020. the sponsors were Lövstrands Café, and they are gifting Rauma Gammel Serie, two threads, two ply, for one pair of socks. And I think that you can pick any color. The winner can pick the colors, and I will add in one of the needle cozies that the lovely lady has been making for me. It's blowing. It's windy now. So that's all I have to say about that, I think. Previous month, I was sponsored by Hobby. It's a Danish yarn company, and the winner was gifted one 100 gram skein of a lovely sock yarn. It's hand dyed, and it's Luxus, it's called. It was from Mayflower is the brand, and I was also gifted. All the gifts that Hobby is giving you, they also gave the same to me. So I was so curious about that yarn because it was so lovely, and I started to make myself a pair of socks also in that yarn, and I think this is Cascade sock yarn, the white. And the variegated yarn is this Luxus yarn from Mayflower Hobby. And it's so soft, super soft and very lovely. And the pattern, I'm sorry to say, it's one of those Kia socks. Three knits and one purl, and then I just made up some stitches as I went along, just to make it a little bit interesting here on the leg. And then a reinforced heel, as I always do, and I left 12 stitches, 6 stitches on each DPN, and then I Kitchener stitched them together, so 12 stitches on each side for the Kitchener stitch in the toe. And yeah, I have a lovely little pair. I really like this look with the contrasting heel cuff and toe. But just to make it a little bit more interesting, I added these little stitches. It also keeps you motivated to knit those. I think I used 5 rows between all the stitches, the new stitches. So it kept me going, and that's a good way to get this get the leg done. So I have another pair for my little box of socks. Done, and I'm happy for them. What am I wearing? I forgot to tell you. I'm sewn this dress. It's from Stoff & Stil, and the pattern is in English, so I'm glad to say that. I will link to the website in the show notes. And it's a wrap dress. I had a picture on Instagram just the other day, and I also made some embroideries on the edges of them. I can put in a picture here so you can see it a little bit closer. And it's a linen fabric, and it's lovely for this time of year with no sleeves. The pattern comes with sleeves, but I chose not to, because this is a typical spring and summer dress, I think. I don't wear this kind of things when it's winter. So I have my knitted sweaters for the winter, so this is a better summer dress, I think. As you can see, I have finished my sweater. My ripped out sweater has now transformed into a lovely cardigan, and I'm so happy for it. It started out as a old sweater that I ripped out and reused the yarn for, and I also added a little extra thread, so I'm holding it double with a super thin brown, just to give it a little warmer color. Yeah, I can put in a picture if you're new here. But if you're old, you have been following me through this journey with this sweater. And if you haven't, please, you can go back a couple of episodes and see this starting. I started this project the 20th of May, so it's not even a month old. So I think it's maybe previous episode or the episode before that I started it. But yes, it's finished and I'm so happy for it. Really, really happy for it. And the thing that I did after I took those pictures, not me, my husband took those pictures, I actually went in and I crocheted a line of crochet inside, both on the top here and also here, because I realized it was a bit unsteady, what do you say, it was a bit floppy up in the neckline, so I just added in those two lines of crochet to make it more stay in place up here. Yes, super lovely. And the buttons are so cute, they are wooden buttons. I can try and put in a picture here so you can see it a bit closer. I ordered them from eBay UK, I think. Super nice. I don't remember actually what I was just googling. Bird buttons, I think. Yes, very nice. And it's knitted from the bottom up, and the sleeves are a little bit too long actually, and that is one more thing. I have been talking about this top down or bottom up, just nosing into what's the good with the one or the other. And that's a negative thing, I must say, because now I ended up with two long sleeves, and it's not so easy. If I would have knitted them from the top and down, I could just have ripped them up and re-knitted them. But now I decided to, I'm folding them up, and it will be nice. It will be perfect. For winter I can always just have them down and use them as extra warmth for the hands. But that's just one more thing to add on the negative side, maybe. It's that you start from the bottom, and it's easier to adjust the length if you knit from the top down. But yeah, I also added, the pattern is from a book, and it's called Ego Strick by Lena Holme Samse, and it looks like this. And I was looking in this book for a pattern that I could knit, and it is a sweater, and I have made it into a cardigan, and I have also added the pockets. And actually, maybe you think I'm a professional or something, but this was the first time I did these pockets, and everybody was so so happy for the tutorial I put up on my YouTube channel. I will add in this tutorial for these pockets in this video very soon. But the reason I put it out as a special episode on my YouTube channel is that if you want to go back and look at it again, if you're doing this in the future, it's easier to find, sorry, I was holding over the microphone, it's easier to find the information if it's not included in a podcast. If it is as a separate video, it's easier to find it when you want to go back. But I will add it here, and you can have a look at how I did these pockets. But it is actually the first time for me as well, because I have never added pockets like this. But you do it with afterthought heel, so I thought that why can't I do it like this? And of course I could. So enjoy the little film, and I will see you soon. Thank you. It's not so hard actually. It was super easy, and yeah, as I said, it's like an afterthought heel, but you just you don't make a heel. You make the separate parts when you open up. You just knit the inside of the pocket and this ribbing. Yes, I am very happy, and I also made a blog post. And if you are on my website, kiasbo.se, there is a little button there, Google Translate. So if you want to read what I have been writing, you can just pick your language, and you can read everything I wrote, because I did write some things on the process of this sweater. Yes, what else can I tell you? It's knitted on 5mm needles and from the bottom up, and I knitted it back and forward. I did not steek this, because you might want to rip it out and do something else. No, I won't. I love this. It's perfect now. And Nemo found it very good that I had pockets in my cardigan now, because now I can have dog treats with me. So he was happy, very happy. You can see that on my latest Instagram post, that he was very thrilled when he found that it was with pockets and with treats. Yes, very good. Yeah, from the bottom up and back and forward, and I added the ribbings afterwards. But I think this is why I had to make it make the crochet lines. It's that this ribbing just kept going on the back here. I think it was half of the neckline is from the stitches and on the cardigan. So when I pick up for a ribbed, like for the bottom bands and also for the neckline, I never pick up all the stitches. I usually pick up 3 out of 4. So I'm leaving a couple of stitches just to bring it back together a little bit. So I think that's why I felt that it was under, it was totally loose. But with this crochet line, I made it a little bit more sturdy, actually. You can see it here, that I did add in a little strength here. And the bottom bands, I picked up like 3 out of 4 afterwards. Yeah, super happy with it, actually. It's very nice. And to make something like this from an old sweater that I wasn't happy with, that I now can use for this, it makes me very happy, actually. So that's my 2 finished objects for today. I have no more finished objects, but I have started a new sweater. I have been watching, I saw this sweater on Instagram, and it was quite a while back, and she was looking for test knitters, and since then I have been waiting for this sweater to for the pattern to come out. And I think it was last week she released the pattern, and it's Simone Pullover, and it is by Gabriella Knits, and she has if you go to her Instagram account, I will link to it. She has this link tree, I think it's called, where you go to her shop, and she has a lot of different things there. So you will be easy to click your way through the Ravelry, to the Ravelry page. And also she has, I think she's in that she dyes yarn as well. But this is the Simone pullover that I have started, and as you can see, I had a lot of fun with the yoke. So I knitted this quite quickly, actually, and I was looking in my yarn stash, and I found an old cascade that I have had for several years in my stash. It's Cascade 220 Superwash. And the sweater is knitted on 6mm needles. And this actually fills it up. It fills up quite good, I think, for 6mm needles. Yeah, knitting along, and it's bubble, and it's texture, and it's like a little bit lacy, and yeah, super happy with it. And I have now knitted 20 centimeters after the yoke, and there is now a textured piece before the ribbing, so that's the next segment on this sweater, and it's also with long sleeves. And I have 3 balls left, so I hope that 1 ball for each sleeve, and then 1 ball maybe for the bottom here. And I am planning to do separate the ribbing, so I will do a split hem with the shorter ribbing in the front and a little bit longer in the back, because this sweater has no short rows in the back. So I'm thinking that maybe I will pull it back, pull it in the front, and then it will rise up in the back, and that's not so good. So I will add a little extra ribbing on the back to make it a bit longer. And then full length sleeves, I was thinking, because this is quite thick yarn, so I don't want to use it in the spring and the summer. So in the winter I want long sleeves. So that's my plan with this one. Very, very nice. I'm so much into this with texture instead of color work right now. That can change, but right now that's that's how I'm feeling. But this one is put aside a little bit, because in Sweden this Friday is midsummer, and I don't know if you celebrate midsummer in your country, but here in Sweden we do. And it's the day where the light, here we have, it gets lighter and lighter, longer and longer days up to midsummer, and then it turns and it slowly gets darker again. So that is midsummer evening, midsummer day. And we dress up like a cross and we hang two rings with flowers, so it's with leaves, with birch leaves on the cross, and then we have those two rings with decorated with flowers, and then we dance around this like cross. I can put in a little film. I actually filmed last midsummer, I filmed a little segment, and this midsummer it will not be a midsummer event, so we will have to celebrate here at our home. What I am doing, also we make wreaths, you call it that, krans we call it, we have in the hair filled with flowers. So for the grandchildren who are now 7 months and 2.5 years, I will crochet like flower wreath. It's like a hairband. I will put in some stretch in the back, like 10 centimeters stretch in the back, and then I will crochet a band. I have just started, but it's with 6 6 stolpar, double crochet, you call it maybe. So it will be like a little headband. And then I will decorate it with different... I have done some small flowers here in pink. And I have also got with turquoise and purple and green. I will try to crochet some leaves, I was thinking, with the green. And then to add all those flowers. So that's my mission for this week, is to crochet two of those little headbands for my grandchildren. We will all be here for midsummer, and we always eat like raw fish, seal, and the new potatoes, fresh potatoes, and sour milk, maybe you call it, and eggs, and onion grass, you call it that. It's like grass that tastes like onion. So this is what we eat on midsummer. Everyone in Sweden does it. And also strawberries and cream, whipped cream. So that's the midsummer tradition here in Sweden. And then we dance around that leafed cross. We call it midsommarstång. Stång. Midsummer... Yeah, something. Midsummer... It's like a cross. Yeah, we call it that. Yes, that's the plans. And... That's what I am making right now. It's what I will be doing. And maybe if there is time left, I want to knit a small tank top for the girl. Would be nice to match with this hairbands. I am making other things as well. It's not only knitting that keeps me occupied. I have also I bought some wooden boxes. They were totally in like this color, clean wood, and I bought some beds. It's black and brown beds, and I painted those boxes to make them a little bit more like antique look. So this one I filled up with buttons, and I also bought a little bigger box, and I have put in a linen fabric here inside, and my plan is to make some embroidery on it, cross stitching actually. I will show you later what exactly my plan is, but this is something that I thought was very nice to do, and also to organize all my things, the buttons, and I have started to pick out some embroidery threads to have in here, the things that I want to embroider with, and I had some DMC embroidery threads. I was gifted last summer from a kind lady here in Sweden who had a lot. So I have picked out some threads here. And also I bought from a shop in Holland, Netherlands. And this is some little bit more exclusive, I think, embroidery thread. And yeah. So lovely colors. I was ordering something else from this shop in Holland, and I saw that they had this nice thread, so I wanted to buy some and try out some other kind of embroidery thread as well, because in Sweden you can only get this DMC. So yeah, nice to when you do the shipping, you could throw in some extra stuff. It's always the shipping that's expensive, I must say. Yeah, so this was from a shop in Holland, and I will link to it if you want to buy. And it's this is it's Simply Shaker is the brand of these threads. Yes, so that is what I have been doing, and I think it's nice to have a nice box to organize the things in. So, yes, don't you think it would be nice with some kind of cross stitch or something on that box? So let's start this story from the beginning, because I have been also starting to look at other podcasts, embroidery and cross stitch, and yes, podcasts that do other things as well. And the first one that I stumbled upon was Sherry Iris podcast, and she is also knitting, and I think she's a hand dyer as well and has an Etsy shop. But she is embroidering, and she is more like freestyle embroidering and more like freestyle embroidering, doing like flowers and the English cottage style. And in her podcast she mentioned a shop called The Stitchery, and I looked that up, and that was so lovely. And I had to order something from that podcast, from that shop. She also has a YouTube channel and a blog and a website with the shop. So I ordered, it's a Stitchery sampler, and it comes like this in a little, holder or something. And in this, it's a Stitchery sampler book. And here you have all the stitches that you need to make the little thing that I bought. So that's very nice to get this little book with all the stitches in. And what I ordered, you also got, of course, the threads you need and the needles. So that was a lovely little kit. And the thing that I will embroider is this. And this is a Stitchery sampler, and it's different kinds of stitches that you do here, and yeah, it's free to use the colors that you want, but it's mostly like trying out different kinds of stitches here. And it says what stitch, and it's pre-printed what you will embroider. So yeah, it's a linen fabric, and so nice, I must say. So I have started a little bit here up in the corner, and enjoying myself with this one. So I also have, when I embroider, I am using this, I think it's a hoop. When I am starting to watch this other kinds of podcasts, there is a totally new language. So I think this is a hoop. Oops. All the different kinds of threads and all the different kinds of fabric. And yeah, this is a whole new world, and it's so exciting. So yes, that's Sherry Iris, and this is The Stitchery, it's called. And she's called Nikki, who has that shop. Okay, that's it. And then I was watching Nicole's Needlework. It's also a podcast, and she has been podcasting for a long time. She has a lot of podcasts, so I have only been watching a couple of them. But in her podcast, she was talking about showing up what she was stitching on, and she was stitching on something from this Blackbird Designs, and it's a lot of cross stitching, super lovely. And on the back of this magazine, this was ordered from Holland, you see where I got the idea of the box with the embroidery linen fabric in the glass box. So in this one I have found a lot of things I want to do, of course. There is pillows, there is boxes, there is small little bags. Yeah, there is a lot of things. But I don't want to this is quite expensive magazines, so I don't want to make notes in this. So I took copies, and then I plan to actually fill in with the colors in these markings, so it's easier to see the colors that I am using. So this is Blackbird Designs, and this is a whole world of different things. So interesting, but there is no way you can find this in Sweden, so I had to order from Holland. And I'm happy that my colleague from work, she is from Holland, so she could Netherlands. I'm saying Holland because we say that in Sweden, but it's Netherlands. So she could translate the website for me. I'm happy for it. I also found some French website I wanted to order from, but I can't understand a word of French. So I'm so sorry, but I couldn't order from that website. But yes, that's it. And then I found another podcast, and it's called Globetrotting Stitcher, and this is a new podcast. She has only been, I think she has 2 episodes out, so that's more it's more likely that you look back, because Nicole Snederberg, she has a lot. You can't look from the beginning, but with this one you can look back those 2 episodes. And she didn't do the cross stitching that I was drawn to, but she is a lovely person, and she is also, it's the whole setup is very professional, and her husband is doing all the editing, and I think that he is a professional, like film editor or something. I think she said that in one of the episodes. Very nice podcast to watch, and I find it very interesting to just listen to all these new things that that they talk about. And there is something on YouTube that's called FlossTube, and it's like a collection, a hashtag they use in the podcasts on YouTube, that all embroidery or cross stitching, I really don't understand 100% what this is, the FlossTube, but it's somehow all the cross stitchers are under this hashtag FlossTube on YouTube. So I was thinking that why don't we have this in the knitting community, that you could look like a KnitTube or something. It's just the way, something that I was thinking. The more I look into this, the more I was thinking that it would be so nice to have one place to look for podcasts about knitting, or like this about cross stitching or something. Yeah, just thinking. But something that popped up when you start to watch stitching podcasts, YouTube starts to suggest, they start to recommend more other stitching podcasts. So that's how I just move in further and further into this. And when you start watching this FlossTube things, they just keep on recommending them. So I was so surprised when I saw Rachel and Sue popping up in this FlossTube, and Rachel is Treehouse Knits, she has a knitting podcast, and Sue is from Legacy Knits, that's also a knitting podcast, she podcasts with her daughter. And they had started a FlossTube podcast, and it's called Floss Toss. And they are talking about their background in cross stitching, and I know because I have seen both of their podcasts, and I knew that they had been doing cross stitching. So yeah, it was a nice surprise, and I watched their episodes, and they did the first episode. And I'm so looking forward to hear more from them, actually, because since this is a new world to me, I'm really just soaking in all the new things and learning new things all the time. And it felt so nice to know the people. Because it feels like you know the podcasters you have been watching. It always feels like you know them. So I will be linking to their new podcast as well. I will be linked to all of these stitching podcasts. And that is how YouTube works. And that is something good. If you are a podcaster and you get this thumbs up and thumbs down and the, yeah. I try to think of the thumbs down as someone who is interested in cars maybe. And then they pop into my podcast and they click thumbs down. And that way YouTube won't recommend any more podcasts like mine to them. So that's how I try to think about the thumbs down. And of course maybe thumbs down is personal to me, but I try to see them as if you don't get think so personal, you think that this is how YouTube works. If I want to see stitchery embroidery podcasts, I'm clicking thumbs up, and that way YouTube knows that she likes to see these kinds of podcasts, so we will keep recommending them to her. And I think that maybe if they started to recommend car podcasts to me, or maybe something that I wasn't interested in at all, maybe I could click thumbs down, not because I didn't like what they did, but because I don't want to be recommended more of this kind of podcasts. Yeah, I don't know. That's just something that I have been thinking about, because even though you get 300 thumbs up and you get 2 thumbs down, it's very easy to get sad about the thumbs down. So I try to think about them as some men who wanted to watch car racing popping into my knitting podcast. Okay, that's just me rambling, but it's a new world, this stitchery podcasting, and I am enjoying myself. There is a lot of thumbs up from my side to the stitchery community, the floss tubes. And I want to say a lot of thank you, of course, to all of you who are nice with your comments and your thumbs up, and also those of you who are buying me a cup of coffee. And that is a way to help me with this podcasting. There is a lot of time going into making podcasts, so if you want to support my work, I would be so grateful. There will be a link under this podcast to coffee.com. And there will also be links to my website, and there you can find links to everything that I talk about today. So I hope that you will pop over, and I know that if you are a regular viewer, you already know all these things. But if you are new here and you wonder, that's why I'm telling you that you can find links to everything on my website. Yes, so there is midsummer here in Sweden soon, and we will be celebrating. So I hope that you have a lovely week, 2 weeks maybe. I will be popping in with a new podcast just before the new month, so that you can get the next sock pattern for the Free Sock 2020. Okay, have a lovely time, and I will see you soon. Bye-bye. Thank you.